Good morning, everyone. Are you hearing me? I thought I was on BBC.
Can you hear me now?
That's better. Good morning, everyone. It's good to see you here. And it's my pleasure to welcome all of you to morning worship in Lowson Memorial. That includes all those at home looking in. Most Sundays at this time is when we give a special mention to those visiting or returning after a break, letting them know how happy we are to see them. Well, today we have a whole bunch of old friends here returning after a break of 3 long years. Yvonne, we're so happy to have you in the band with us this morning, leading the worship. And can I say, all looking not a day older than you were in 2019. I mean Yvonne, not the rest of you. And we're also looking forward to your wonderful carol concert this evening. As always, there's a very special welcome for the youngsters here. This is a family service. We're all staying in the church this morning. But if you're under 3 and feel restless at any time during the service, get Mum and Dad to take you across to play with the nice ladies in the creche. Yes, this is third Sunday in Advent, as the youngsters would say, only 14 sleeps from Christmas Day, which is a long time to be on our best behavior. But you know, I find it easier to be good in church because here we're all part of our bigger family, God's family here in the Lowson. And we want everyone to know that there's always room for more of us. So let's share the warmest of greetings with those around us, if you wish, by signing, God loves you. God loves you. Running quickly through the intimations, the Tots Toddlers group again meets on Monday, Wednesday and Friday mornings. Men's Guild have their Christmas meal out on Tuesday. Wednesday evening, we have Cafe Church, our monthly not-to-be-missed informal worship and praise with the praise band. Our midweek service of worship elevenses, the lunch club, the craft group and the men's prayer group all meet on Thursday. The lunch club being served with festive fare for their last meeting in 2022, before returning on 5th January. And the youth groups in Drop Zone have their Christmas parties on Friday evening before breaking for the school holidays. We continue our Warm Space Initiative, or Heat Hub, every weekday afternoon, 2 to 5 in the hall, complementing similar provision in East and Old and St. Margaret's, and hoping for a better uptake of the facilities we provide. Next Sunday, the 4th in Advent, we have the Nativity with the youngsters and what promises to be another big, happy family service, starting at 11 o'clock. In the afternoon, we'll be holding a quiet, reflective memorial service starting at 2 o'clock, to which all are welcome, particularly those who find this a difficult time of the year or who have lost a loved one. In the evening, St. Margaret's are again hosting the Forfar Church's big sing, starting at 7 o'clock. And I have to make special mention and give a great welcome to a special person with us today, also returning after a break. It's Sadie, Sadie Silver, sitting at the front there, winking to me. But wait for it. Sadie will be 100 on the 4th of January. Well done. Finally, please don't rush off after the service, but come and have a cup of tea or coffee and continued friendship down here in the South Transept, while the band hopefully enjoy some lunch across in the hall before fulfilling their next engagement. Yvonne, that's me. Now for you again.
We're back.
Yes.
If you're like us, we wondered during this 3 year period where things have just not been normal, have they? If we would ever be back having this opportunity to minister to you today. And we just give all the praise to God that, you know, he's gifted people, medical people, a whole queen of people who have gifts, who've allowed us to be able to get back into some sort of normality. And so today, we just want to take maximum opportunity to share the word of the Christmas story and the impact that that has had and can continue to have in the world that we live in. And boy, does the world need it, doesn't it? Definitely. But today, the third Sunday of Advent is called the Sunday of Rejoicing. And so I'm going to ask you if you're able to stand and join with us in our opening carol. Now, you're in the Salvation Army this morning, is that okay? So we don't do any introductions, it's right into the song, is that okay? Say yes, Yvonne. Yes. Excellent. So if you're able to, stand. If not, just stay in the comfort of your seat, and we're going to sing, Come Thou Long Expected Jesus. Thank you.
Shall we pray? Dear Heavenly Father, we give you thanks this morning that we can freely meet here in your house. We think of those around the world who don't have the freedom that we have, the freedom to worship, the freedom that we can praise your name with all our might. We think, Lord, of the people within this church, for those who may not be able to make it to the service. May you be with them, whatever their circumstances. We think back to Bellsill for our own who are of the same, who can't be there for whatever circumstance. May you be with them. We think, Lord, of today, which is the third day of Advent, the day where we think of the joy there is of Christ who died, who was born in the stable, who later died in the cross, that we, each one, may have life and have life ever after. Thank you, dear Father, and we simply ask that you will be in whatever happens today, whatever conversation which may take place, however small, it may be something of a blessing to whoever we're speaking to. And may we go out into the world for the rest of the week, refreshed, praising your joyous name. In your Son's name we ask this. Amen.
I guess this service this morning is going to be slightly different. In the band, we want to minister through word and song, but also through our music. And so for a lot of what we're going to share with you this morning, I'm just going to let it roll, okay? And just hope that you really feel that we're in the presence of God as we share in the music. We're going to share in a piece just now entitled Coventry Carol.
Thank you. Good morning. Sorry, I had to fight my way out from the back there. I was wondering if the children, I've spotted three, there may be more, would like to come and join me. Are you brave enough? If I sit down here and try not to look scary. Oh, I've got some coming. Well, that's all right. You can listen from there. There's two coming. I'm going to have a little seat. No! I'm so popular today. Oh, I found a friend. Two. Thank you. Do you want to come and have a step? Come and share my seat. And who are you?
I'm Alex.
And?
Sarah.
Hello, Alex and Sarah. Who's your friend over there? Do you know his name? No, no. Good morning, anyway. Now, I've brought my friend with me. This is my angel, and she's called Angela, right? Funnily enough. And I've had her for a long, long time. And she's got a special trick, which is one of the reasons I quite like her. She's got the wobbliest arms around. She's a bit of a silly angel. But my tree got bigger, so I've given her to my daughter now. But what do angels do? What do angels do in the Bible? Can you think of anything that they do?
Tell the shepherds.
Wow, super. They tell the shepherds. They bring good news, don't they? And we all love good news. Good news is exciting. Have you got any news that you could share? Anything at all? Yes, good.
Christmas.
Oh, perfect answer. Christmas. Any other good news? No. Well, there's some gentlemen in the band. Two of them have got good news. Oh, good morning.
Borders people, Angus Council people, whatever it is. The Bethlehem Herald angels spread greatest news.
Good morning. Thank you. Could we have some, please? Possibly give them some they could give to their friends, another? Well, we'll leave them at the side and they can get them. Oh, you want money? Have you got any money? Thank you. Now, this is a little newspaper. And it tells about exactly what you mentioned, which was the fact that the shepherds told the angels told the shepherds the good news. Now, if you think of some of the things that we get excited about, news that we have, you might have got something really special for Christmas one year, a teddy bear, a car, and you get really excited. I got excited when my baby was born. I had two babies, but one of them's sitting behind me in the band, and it's not quite so exciting, that news, anymore. And a lot of the news, oh, she is now sobbing quietly, not the new baby news, but some of our news that we get really, really excited about, a few years later, it's not so important. But this news, and what I'd like you to remember today, and perhaps somebody will read it to you later, is the greatest news ever. And you mentioned that the angels came and told of Jesus at his birth. And the reason I decided to talk to you about this today was we have a choir in Bells Hill, and it's young people your age, and this is what they sang last Sunday, if I find it. Shepherds hastened to the stable where the holy infant lay, as the wise men from the east bring precious gifts to him this day. Can this baby in the manger really save us from our sins? Hallelujah, what a saviour. This is Jesus Christ the King. And from Luke verse 2, here's what the angel said. Don't be afraid, because I am bringing you some good news, the greatest news. It will be a joy to all people today. Your Savior was born in David's town. He is Christ the Lord. So that's what I want you to remember. This news has lasted 2,000 years, and it's the best news of all. And I think my deep pockets, if you're allowed, might have some chocolate for you as well. All right? And I think we'll get your friend. Thank you so much for your help. And there's some copies there. If you want to give them to your friends and share, you can. Thank you very much.
Are you feeling relaxed? Convince me. Yeah? Yeah? Well, I'm hoping this next piece, we're going to be waltzing. If you feel free, you know, to express however you're feeling, here's a waltz entitled A Holy Waltz.
Okay, it's your turn to sing again and to dig into your pockets as well. We're going to sing the very well-known carol that came upon a midnight clear to the traditional setting. Okay, so there are three verses. I'm a great believer if you stand up, then your pockets are more readily accessible. So we'll stand if you're able and we'll sing this. There are three verses. Again, we'll do no introduction. Okay, and it's your chance to give in this morning's offering. Thank you.
Thank you. Let's just give thanks for the offering. Let's pray. Loving God, we thank you for your many, many blessings. And we are truly blessed today to have our friends from Bells Hill back here with us. We thank you, Lord, that you bless us abundantly. Forgive us when we take you so much for granted. Forgive us when we take your resources for granted. And today we make our gifts to you. We ask that you would accept them, Lord, and bless them, that we could use these gifts to touch others with your great love, that they too would know your blessing on their lives. We ask in Jesus' name. Amen.
We'd like to introduce to you our first soloist of the day, Chris Shanks. Chris is our YP band leader, so that means he looks after our junior band. And also a divisional, or kind of area youth band in the west of Scotland within the Salvation Army. And he's going to bring not a Salvation Army piece of music in any way. It's called The Seal Lullaby, originally written by a very gifted composer called Eric Whittaker, who is a Grammy Award-winning composer and composed this piece of music ultimately in a failed bid for a soundtrack for an animated film. But it's gained traction over the last decade, 20 years almost, as a piece of music. And it's been arranged by a gifted Salvation Army composer called Paul Sharman down in London. And this is The Seal Lullaby, and Chris, our euphonium soloist, will come and play that for you. Thank you.
Hi. So there's two Bible verses that I'm bringing today. Both of them are from the Voice translation. The first is Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6, which says, "Hope of all hopes, dream of our dreams, a child is born, sweet breath, a son is given to us, a living gift. And even now, with tiny features and dewy hair, he is great. The power of leadership and the weight of authority will rest on his shoulders. His name? His name will know in many ways. He will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Dear Father Everlasting, Ever Present, Never Failing, Master of Wholeness, Prince of Peace." And then the other is John chapter 3, verse 16. "For God expressed his love for the world in this way. He gave his only Son, so that whoever believes in him will not face everlasting destruction, but will have everlasting life."
Thank you. Hello. Good morning to you. It's lovely to see you gathering with us in this special day for us, and I believe also a special day in the life of Lowson Church here. Now, I've been asked to say this morning, what does Christmas mean to me? Well, in the first instance, this particular aspect of Christmas is very, very different for me. Because for the last number of years, I don't know how many, I think we're probably getting into the 20s, are we? Yeah, we're getting into the 20s. I have been where you are now, and that is sitting in the congregation, listening to the music played by this fine Salvation Army band. I retired recently, yeah. I retired just towards the end of May, and I moved back down to the Central Belt area after living in Aberdeen for 30 years, working for the Salvation Army there for just about 25 years. And really, how many years have I been keeping Jim McCluskey right? Probably the vast number of those 20-odd years that I was working for the Salvation Army, but it's particularly nice for me to meet up with Jim and Sandra again. Very, very good friends of mine over many, many years. So what does Christmas mean to me? Well, let's kind of take a step back just now. Am I the only one who thinks that the days in December seem to be shorter and they go rather quickly? Yeah, that seems to be the case for me, and that can develop into perhaps utter chaos with what has got to be achieved during those first 24 days of Christmas time. But for me, I've taken a step back from the hubbub that's going on around about me in preparation for Christmas time. And I've been looking at my Salvation Army songbook, which is our equivalent of your church hymnary. I don't know if you still use church hymnary. Have you kind of moved on a bit since then? But we have a Salvation Army songbook, as well as many, many other songbooks that we use. But I'm a great lover of this, and it's a open very, very regularly, because contained within it is such scriptural truths that help me in my daily walk. So in this Advent season, I've been paying particular attention to the songs that are contained within the Advent and Birth of Jesus section in our Salvation Army songbook. I don't know about you here at Lowson, but I think there's some children around. They were out with Joan earlier on. But we are very, I was going to say, lucky's not the word. We're very blessed at Bells Hill, where we have a vast number of youngsters, from young babies through to toddlers and beyond. So as I've been looking at my Salvation Army songbook over these last days, I've kind of been looking beyond the baby. Now, we celebrate the baby, and we've been singing about the baby, and we will continue to sing about the infant king throughout this morning and again this evening. But one song in particular that has caught my eye as I've been reading through my songbook, and it speaks really about the life of Jesus. A boy was born in Bethlehem. A boy grew up in Nazareth. A young man walked by Galilee. On Calvary, a young man died. On Easter morning, Jesus came. So really, within that song, we have the whole life of our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ. Now, we read words in Isaiah 53. But he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was upon him, and by his wounds we are healed. That for me is what Christmas means to me. Yes, We have the babe in the manger. But look beyond the babe to absolutely everything that Christ offers to each and every one of us as we seek to serve him. So, what does Christmas mean to me? It's elation. It's joy. It's thankfulness for the goodness of God and everything that I can find in and through him. Isaiah wrote the story of Jesus and the story of our salvation 700 years before it happened. The baby Christ child is not to be taken lightly. He was a teacher. He did not come as a teacher, but he taught. He did not come as a healer, but he healed. But he was sent as a substitute in our place. He took our punishment, my punishment. Before I came to the Salvation Army, I was a member of the... Well, I wasn't a member. I suppose I was too young to be a member in those days. I was a member of the Church of Scotland down in Greenock. And that was the days where you had your name on the pew. So the name Scott was in that pew. And woe betide anybody who wasn't a Scot who sat in that pew. Yeah, they were days. Yeah, really, thank the Lord we've moved on. But I do remember, so it would be probably 50 plus years ago, at a watch night service, the then minister, who was the Reverend Andrew McClellan, who went on to become the moderator, he made reference to a Christmas song, and I'm going to make a reference to it this morning to you. So, this is Christmas, and what have you done? Spread a little joy, folks. That's what we can do this morning. And for the remainder of the 14 days, did I hear? Yeah. So this is Christmas. And what have you done? Let's spread a little joy about the Christ child who became and who was our Saviour. Thank you.
We're going to share with you just now, I would imagine, one of the first carols that we probably learned as a young child, and in the form of a delightful cornet solo featuring Alex, our principal cornet player. Alex actually is my son-in-law, but he played it for his four-year-old daughter on Friday night. No pressure. It was just a delightful arrangement of this lovely carol. Take us back to our childhood and actually to the roots of the Christmas story. Alex, please, with Away in a Manger.
Thank you. It's a real privilege and a pleasure to be with you. This is my first time in Forfar, first time here with the band. My wife and I retired at the end of 2019, and we decided we would worship with our good friends in Bells Hill, and it's lovely to be able to come and to share with you today. Being a man, I don't often get involved in Christmas shopping. Some people are tutting, but I think it's the ladies who are tutting rather than the men. One thing I always used to do on Christmas Eve, I would go out with my daughter and get something for my wife. But we always left it, or I always left it, until Christmas Eve. Somehow that seemed to be the right thing to do, because I was so busy Christmas caroling and doing all these things that we do in the Salvation Army. That was my excuse anyway. But one of the things that I'm sure we notice, and especially the children will too, is all the television adverts at Christmas time. I have a daughter and her husband who both work for McDonald's. So one of the things we've always got to do is to look for the McDonald's advert, as well as try and go and spend money in McDonald's because it keeps them in a job. But we keep on looking at these adverts, and especially at this kind of time, there's so much competition for adverts. One of my favorite ones, maybe it's being Scottish, is the Iron Brew advert. They've had one and then followed by a sequel, and I've been waiting this year to see what happens the third time. For those of you that maybe need a little bit of reminder, the snowman takes the little boy, and the little boy's got his can of Iron Brew, and he tries to steal his can of Iron Brew, but the little boy won't have any of it. He holds on to that can of Iron Brew. And the snowman's flying through the air, and horrible, horrible, he lets the little boy go. And the little boy falls into the snow. Fortunately, there was a lot of snow in George Square in Glasgow, and the little boy fell into the snow. I'm wondering, where's the next Iron Brew advert? They try and get us on that television to buy all these kinds of things. How many of you wait to see the Coca-Cola truck? The Coca-Cola truck. Anybody seen it? Yes? Oh, the Coca-Cola truck. I would like to see the Coca-Cola truck, and I would like to see the Coca-Cola train, which would be even better, wouldn't it, to see a big Coca-Cola train? Well, there's always all this competition for adverts. But I wonder if you remember the John Lewis advert from a few years ago, entitled Man on the Moon. Little girl, looking through a telescope at the moon. And eventually, she manages to get this telescope focused on the moon. And what does she see? A little, elderly, lonely man. A little, elderly, lonely man. Reminding us, at Christmas, there are people who are on their own. We need to remember them and care for them, and invite them round, even if it's only for a mince pie. If they like mince pies, of course. But invite them round. Well, there was a particular Christian worker in Liverpool who was quite concerned about this, and he decided, he was called Dan Rackman, and he decided that he was actually going to update this advert and give his explanation of it. And he says this: Christmas is such a good time to think about how God has loved us And we wanted to give people an opportunity to do that. And I know that some of my friends think about that, but some of them don't in their day-to-day lives. So why not get people to think how they've been loved this Christmas? He continues, like most people, I loved the advert. But I'd love for people to look down the other end of the telescope this Christmas. When it comes to giving gifts, I believe it's God who has given us the ultimate gift. Actually coming down to us. That's what Christmas is all about. Let's watch the video.
I would like to leave this city, this old town, don't smell too pretty. I can feel the warning signs running around my mind. And when I leave this planet, you know I'd stay, but I just can't stand it. And I can feel the warning signs running around my mind. So here I go, I'm still scratching around in the same old hole. My body feels young, but my mind is very old. So what do you say? You can't give me the dreams, it ain't mine anyway. You're half a world away. Yeah, you're half.
We are loved. God loves us so much. And the wonderful thing is, even if we don't love him, he still loves us. Now that doesn't make sense, but it's a fact. Even if we don't love God, he still loves us. He still cares for us. He sent his son, Jesus, to come as a baby, to be born in a stable, not in a palace, to grow up with all the pressures of childhood, and then at the age of 12, to go to the temple and have that little bit of an insight into his future ministry. And then at age 30, to commence his life's ministry. Christmas is complete on Easter Sunday morning. God sent Jesus to purchase for you and me our full salvation. Not so that we could actually do lots of work to get it, because we can't. No matter how good we are, and no matter how often we come to church, that's not enough. Jesus gave his life for you and for me because he loves us. The band are going to play a lovely piece. Some of the words that go with it. Jesus, good above all other, gentle child of gentle mother, in a stable born our brother, give us grace to persevere. And with the economic situation that we're in just now, give us grace to persevere. And may I add, let's also share some of God's love with our neighbour. Lord, in all our doings guide us. Pride and hate shall ne'er divide us. We'll go on with thee beside us. And on this third Sunday in Advent, with joy, we'll persevere.
Our prayer is that this morning you've felt closer to Jesus. closer to that stable and the vibrancy of the of that, that story, which is still as pertinent today as it was those 2,000 years ago. Please join us as we come to the end of our service in singing one of my favourite carols, Joy to the World. Again, if you're able to stand, that's great. If not, if in your seat, you need to sing even louder if you're sitting down, okay? So no introduction, straight in with Joy to the World.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. That was absolutely brilliant. Folks, please stay behind for some refreshments. We're just having our refreshments in the church today to allow the bandsmen to get fed over in the hall. So please come forward and have some refreshments down here with us. Thank you.